along in Lochmaben town. How he did go to fair England to steal King Henry's wanton brown. First he went to his good wife with all the speed that he could throw. This war, quoth he, will never work without a mare that has a foe.
Oh, she that has a good grey mare that'll run over hills both low and high. Take the grey mare in thy hand, leave the foal at home with me.
Take a halter in thy hose and of thy purpose do not fail.
Walk a toe the wanton snows, tie it to the grey mare's tail.
He is up to England gone, even as fast as he could hide. Until he came to King Henry's gate, and who was there but King Henry?
Then says he, you silly blind harper, and have thy harp and let me hear. Oh, by my seat, cries the silly blind harper, rather a stable and for my mare.
The king looks over his left shoulder, says unto his stable groom,
go tie the silly blind harper's mare well beside my wanton brown.
Aye he harped and aye he carpet till all the nobles went through the floor. They thought the music was so sweet, they forgot the stable door. Aye he harped and aye he carpet till all the nobles were sound asleep.
Quietly he took off his shoes, softly down the stairs did creep.
Took the halter from his hose, and of his purpose he did not fail. He slipped it over the wanton nose, tied it to the grey mare's tail. Daylight, as they had ended all their cheer, King Henry's wanton brown was stolen, also the poor old harper's mare. Alas, alas, cries a silly blind harper, alas, alas, it came I here.
In Scotland I lost my good cat foal, now in England I've stolen my good grey mare.
Hold your tongue, you silly blind harper, and of thy alas it let me be. For you shall get a better mare, well paid will your clout full be.